Identify yourself and your storyline.
Ahmed Mulcahy.
Yeah, go on, brother.
I came here December the 9th.
2017? Thank you very much.
I was put into one of the rooms 1112 with two Moroccan guys.
1112? Is that downstairs? And this is?
And this is 115.
115.
Before they moved me, the two people that were there, two Moroccan guys, they broke into my locker, stole my keys, stole all my stuff.
Wait. They broke into there, and they broke into that locker.
Well, yeah?
Can you repeat that again? Two Moroccan guys?
Two Moroccan guys stole my key. At first, they stole my key. When I got my key back, they broke into my locker.
Okay.
Literally took all my clothes, my stereo that I had on the side is gone.
All your property?
All my property, everything.
Was there any pictures and any information on your family?
I went to the offices, they said they'll be.
Was there anything of valuable?
That family, trainers,
family,
pictures.
Kids. Pictures, everything is gone, even some of my paperwork.
Okay.
When I told the officers about it, they said they will investigate.
Okay.
And I kept asking them for 2 weeks, they said, we'll investigate. They moved me to Dewey. I refused to go to Dewey. I said I wanted to stay in Dewey.
Can you please say again, when did this offence take place, the day and time?
Well, then it's been a story.
You have to repeat so people know what's going on.
You can cut it.
Yeah.
Yeah. This offence taking place December the 20th.
December 20th, and you've been chasing up for 2 weeks.
Yeah, I've been chasing it for 2 weeks. The boy, the person that robbed my stuff, they went to check his cell. In his cell, they found hooch, yeah? That person came back to me when I was up here saying to me, I owe him money for the hooch. Mm-hmm. And I said to him, I'm not paying for it, yeah? They're searching his room because he stole my stuff. He kept trying to bully me for 2 weeks, yeah? To get a tenner off me. One day he come up here and said, you're going to pay me the tenner today. I said, I'm not paying you nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Literally just grabbed me outside and buy me, yeah? There was witnesses here that saw.
Okay.
Yeah, they said to the officers, this boy is getting bullied by these guys, yeah? They've been telling him for about a week, yeah? Spider. If you remember Spider.
Who's the witness?
Huh?
Who's the witness?
Spider, he's gone now.
Yeah?
I can get his details, yeah?
Okay.
And he basically told them that this boy's getting bullied, sort it out, yeah? Now they, anyway, I got headbutted, got taken to the nurse. The nurse said he had to go to hospital, get 5 stitches.
Okay.
The manager refused. I went to the management after I got the butterfly stitches saying I want to get the police involved. He said to me, no, we do that. We do that on our end. We get the police involved. It's better coming from us. Mm-hmm. 8 weeks went on. I'm thinking that they're sorting it out. Like I'm chasing them saying, that's the police people are saying yes, yes. After the 8 weeks, they come to me and said, no, nobody's running the police. You can ring the police yourself. And I said, what do you mean?
8 weeks after the 20th of December.
Yeah, it was a manager called Dave. Said, you can ring the police yourself. I said, but you said to me you were going to ring the police. He goes, no, we don't do that. If you want me to help you out, I can ring the police.
Okay.
I rang the police. Police came 2 days after. And the police were wondering why they're taking them 8 weeks. I said to the police, they said that they were going to ring the police. And they said it was my responsibility.
To check up on it.
The police said that's a lie. They said it's their premises, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And obviously the police are trying to investigate it now.
Looked up by G4, so they
the police said now we're trying to investigate, but the chances are this person has been deported
or released.
It might be too late. Now I'm trying to get a meeting with them again about my stuff. They give me a letter to say there's only a jacket went missing and a phone. Yeah? It's a lie. Most of my stuff went missing.
But the important bit is the way that you got caught and they didn't take you to the hospital.
Another question was I going to say, when you came in here, did anyone bring you any clothes or anything? Was it registered on your name?
I sent me all my stuff. It's all recorded.
Okay, so all those stuff went missing and they only said, we have this.
One jacket. Missing on the phone.
And they said this is the only thing that's missing.
That's what I'm missing. And I said to them,
okay, thank you. And one more question. What is your view on the take on Brook House and what you have been seeing? Are there anything that you want to highlight quickly that you've been seeing?
I don't feel safe in here.
Mm-hmm.
The only time I really feel safe is when my cell is shut. But obviously I can't spend all day in my cell. I've got paperwork to do and that.
It's room.
And they're conflicting. If you go to somebody and make a complaint, the person never passed it on to management.
Okay. Alright, thank you very much for your time. And if you know anyone else that has similar issues, please tell us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
God bless you.